These days, many Christians, especially college-age students, find their faith in God and the Bible questioned, if not downright assaulted.
Sometimes they'll have a professor that's going to outright challenge why they believe what they believe and say, look, what you believe is actually a fairy tale.
Not so, according to three of the world's top biblical experts, who told CBN News there's good reason to have faith in your faith.
The faith is very, very defendable. That's why it's lasted for 2,000 years.
They point to how even respected non-believers wrote about Jesus.
16 total historians, apart from the scripture, everything else, that reference Christ. Almost everything about Christ we can find out without ever going to the New Testament.
The fact is, surviving manuscripts we have for almost any ancient writings were produced hundreds of years after those original writings.
Jonathan Morrow tells students at the Impact 360 Institute there's more evidence that Jesus lived than Julius Caesar, yet no one doubts Caesar existed. Also, a rule is the closer in time the writer was to events, the more likely his account is accurate. Peter, John, and James lived with Jesus.
John said, what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, what our hands have handled is what we're declaring unto you. In other words, we were eyewitnesses. We were there.
And Morrow points out Paul and Luke interviewed them and knew many others who witnessed Jesus' life, death, and resurrection.
When you're doing history, you want early and you want eyewitnesses. And the gospel writers give you both. They investigated everything carefully. They have the ring of truth to them. They include embarrassing details.
Another understanding among scholars?
What the age does, they find the closer the manuscript to the original, less chance of error or miscopying.
But McDowell explains no original copies exist of the most well-respected and accepted ancient works.
When you look at Greek and Roman historians like Herodotus and Tacitus and Livy, those are hundreds of years later, 500, 600, 700 years after the fact.
Bible manuscripts, though, get closer to the original work than any other.
We've got manuscripts and fragments that show up within 35, 40 years of the time when they were written. Why does that matter? It means there's not enough time for error in mythology to corrupt the message of what's going on there.
Second, the more manuscripts you have, the easier it is to reconstruct the original.
Here, the surviving ancient copies or pieces of the Bible way outnumber all others.
66,420 some manuscripts and scrolls.
McDowell says second place is Homer's The Iliad with just 1,800.
We do trust Homer. How much more so should we trust the New Testament documents?
With so many more copies, no surprise there'd be occasional errors. And critics claim there are some 400,000 mistakes or variants in the Bible. Well,
99% of those 400,000 or so number evaporate, simple spelling errors, word order.
Like H-O-N-O-R, H-O-N-O-U-R.
But none of those texts that are in question affect any central teaching of Christian doctrine or practice.
And Bach and Morrow explained to students many of the so-called contradictions in the Bible are just different ways of telling the same story.
And difference does not equal contradiction, it's just difference.
Doubters have a hard time believing that the Bibles we're reading today could accurately reflect the actual words written by the authors so many centuries ago.
But McDowell explains how for Jewish scribes, copying books like Genesis and Exodus was holy work and strictly controlled.
4,000 regulations the scribe had to follow to guarantee accuracy.
Monks had tight rules for copying as well. Another reason to trust the Bible, archaeology and related research have time and again shown the Bible's true and Bible skeptics wrong.
Archaeology has probably cleared up already over half of all what appeared to be alleged discrepancies in the scriptures.
Skeptics would say there's no record of a Nazareth, so the New Testament can't be true, and no record of the Hittites, so the Old Testament can't be true. Well, archaeology and associated research shows both existed.
But now you can go to Harvard or anywhere else and study the Hittite language.
Finally, there's the proof of logic. The apostles kept saying to their opponents,
you know what I'm talking about. You were there.
McDowell points out that's a crazy thing to do if you're making the whole thing up.
They appealed to the knowledge of their opponents for the facts of which they talk about. To me, that's one of the best tests of truth historically.
Bach asked what better proof the earliest disciples weren't making it all up than the fact they almost all were martyred for it.
You don't die knowingly for something that you know you made up.
Paul Strand, CBN News.